Yo, what's going on? You're tuned into the On The Beat Podcast. Make sure you follow us on IG at onthebeat.podcast. This is your boy, Supa Mario, and you're tuned in to the On The Beat Podcast. Let's go.
Yeah, you on the beat, talking on the beat, learning on the beat, watching on the beat. Get your skills up, won't you listen up? Yeah, you tuned in live, yeah, you on the beat,
boy, Supa Mario, man. I have a very special guest with me, man. I have my artist right here, Mr. Wrecka. What's good with you, bro?
What's crack?
For sure, man. Not much, man. You know, a lot of people don't know who you are, man. So I'm going to let this podcast get started and introducing Mr. Wrecka, man. Go ahead and tell the people a little bit about yourself.
What's cracking? What's cracking, man? It's your boy, Wrecka, a.k.a. Kylie Hayes, man, coming from Southwest Louisiana. Currently residing on the north side of Houston, you know what I'm saying? Bringing a lot of heat to the game and a lot of Wrecktifiedness.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, man. So, you know, he's bringing all of that to you guys and originality, talented, very talented artist right here, man. So, Wrecka, man, kind of let the people know, man, how you got started in your music career and what made you, you know, want to get into this music industry.
Shoot, man, coming up, I come from a musically inclined family. Man, that's all I ever really been around was music. Of course, going to church all the time, you know what I'm saying? But I mean, started off, I think, like, man, me and my cousins used to always be to my grandmother's house when we was like about 10 or 11 years old. And we was always like freestyling, like emulating what we hearing and stuff like that. At that time, you know what I'm saying? That was like playing around on cassette tapes and stuff like that when CDs was like just hitting the market heavy.
Yeah.
So, man, we'll cut on, you know, somebody's song and be rapping over the beats and stuff like that. And as I was getting older, I just always found myself just writing lyrics and, you know, just vibing to a beat in my head or something like that. I could never, even when I would try to not think about it, it's just something that I would always think about. So I was like, shoot, man, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. And of course, with solid people, you know, around me that kept, you know, letting me know, like, over the course of time, like, man, you need to come out with something, you need to do something. So I was like, no, I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, buzz the gang wide
open. Yeah, yeah, that's what's up, man. That's what's up. So, you know, when people, you know, saying hear your name, Wrecka, I'm quite sure questions come about far as, you know what I'm saying, how you got your name. And a lot of people like to hear the backstory on how that artist got their rap name or whatnot. So can you explain to us, you know what I'm saying, what made you choose the name Wrecka? You know what I'm saying? Kind of give us a little general synopsis on that.
Man, it's funny because honestly, I didn't even choose that name. I got that name from busting a nigga ass in the studio on the mic.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah.
I was chilling in the studio one night. Actually, I just got to the studio, and they was up in there holding a freestyle session. And at the time, like, I wasn't even really battle rapping. Mm. So when I walked in the studio, soon as the dude laid eyes on me, he was on the mic. He started just ranking on me, you know what I'm saying? So, man, my partners around me, like, man, grab a mic. Mm-hmm. So, see, I grabbed a mic and I put that nigga in the corner. His homeboy came behind him. I put that nigga on in the corner. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't about to be played with. So,
yeah.
In the midst of that, while I'm busting his ass, I started harmonizing. So, I think I saved his soul that night, and you know, he started repenting.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. That's what's up. So you basically go in the studio and you basically kind of like wrecking the mic, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Hey, man. So you must be good at far as putting together songs real fast or whatnot, right?
Yeah, that don't take me long at all. Mm. Man, as soon as I, you know, hear a beat, I'm just a whole different person in the studio than what I am in a normal day life. Like, I don't know what it is. It's something about just, you know, hearing those tracks and the vibration of what's going on around me.
Uh-huh.
I just feed off of that energy.
Yeah, that's what's up. And I know when you rapping, a lot of times, you know what I'm saying, you say Hook Assassin, man, kind of like, you know what I'm saying, give a little bit about that as well. And that's kind of like, what, a nickname for yourself as well? Kind of like Wrecka, a.k.a. Hook Assassin, a.k.a. Callie Hayes, like your alter ego name, so to speak?
Something like that. Hook Assassin is more of that came about because, man, every time I would do a feature with somebody, I'd be, man, you're killing that hook. Not that I can't rap, you know what I'm saying? Because I murder the verses too, but it was just always when somebody would hit me up, it was rarely about a verse. They would be like, man, I need a hook. And I was just bringing the hooks different from where I'm from. Uh-huh. It was different to those cats, you know, down there. Like, they ain't heard nobody from that area come through on the hooks and shit like that. So, Hook Assassin, I came up with that. Cause I just, you know, like I said, everybody was around me just kept telling me like, man, you killing these hooks.
That's what's up, man. That's good, bro. Also too, man, also when you rapping and stuff like that, like a couple of songs that you got out, you mentioned things like hip hop blues or whatnot. Can you explain to the people, you know, saying what hip hop blues is and what it represents to you?
Sure, man. A lot of pain and soul, is what I put into my art. A lot of the music that I was doing and came up hearing always for some reason kind of had like that blues feel to it. So you know, whenever I'm doing my thing and singing, you know, my hooks, or whenever I start harmonizing in my verses, it have a blues feel to it. You know what I'm saying? It just puts you in that zone, like. Yeah, he know what he talking about, and I'm probably helping somebody get through their day, you know, off of something that I'm talking about. That's the only way I could really put it. Just that soul fulfilled.
Okay, and hip hop blues is kind of like your brand, so to speak, right?
Right.
If I'm understanding correctly.
Right. Right. Okay. That's a style that a genre that I invented. One day I was just playing some stuff that I had, and man, it just popped in my head, like, man, hold up, hip-hop blues. Because I always wanted to be different. I always wanted to set myself apart from what everybody else was doing. And I ain't want, you know, I just didn't want to be put in that same category, which it ain't no hate, you know what other people got going on, but I just didn't want to be put in that same category with every other artist, you know what I'm saying?
Gotcha. Like,
when you hear that song, you're going to know, all right, that's record.
Okay, cool, man. What nicely said, man. So hip hop blues, man. We're gonna definitely be looking out for more music like that, man. So let's talk about the album. You know what I'm saying? You got Wrecktified, just came out on all DSP digital streaming platforms. That's what that means right there. And you know, kind of tell us a little bit about the album Wrecktified, man. Kind of, you know, saying for the people that's kind of curious on that album and everything like that, and they want to check it out. And we have a lot of people like to check out albums according to the title. So kind of explain the album and also the title.
Man, Wrecktified. That's a special one right there. The title come from the actions that you know I used to cause. Pretty much saying it like, man, what I used to do, I was real reckless. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Was out of control. Just headed down a dark path. And, you know, not to get it confused with Wrecktify or nothing like that. Rrecktify.
With an R,
that,
right?
Right,
yeah,
right,
yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah. You got some slow people out there. You got to, yeah,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
That title, you know what I'm saying, pretty much is just saying like, all right, I was this, now I'm this. You know, the community dictionary might look at it like somebody that's alcoholic or something like that. When I'm just taking that term and flipping it, you know what I'm saying? Like, all right, I'm about, y'all about to be Wrecktified.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? You don't ever know it, but when you listen to that, it gonna do some damage to you, but in a positive way. You know, it ain't nothing negative up on there. None of that, you know what I'm saying? Because like I said, one of these songs might help somebody get through their day. You know what I'm saying? I'm probably, right. You know, off of my personal experiences, I'm probably letting somebody else know, like, man, it's all right to go through this. And
right, right.
On the other side, it is another side.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Shoot, man. And that's what I think right now, you know what I'm saying, the music industry needs some type of positive reinforcement without having to always act tough and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? That shit kind of getting old or whatnot. But, you know, your music, regardless of how it comes off, like you said, you know what I'm saying, is positive reinforcement for someone that's really kind of going through something or whatnot. You make them at the situation and make them really think. We need more thinking music out here in the hip-hop industry, man. And the hip-hop community too as well, man. That's what's up, man. So let's talk about your singles, man. Trying to Survive, which was your first single, right?
Correct.
First ever single?
Officially, yeah.
Officially? Okay, yeah. Okay. And also End of Times, which was your other single as well. So explain to us Trying to Survive and what that title mean.
Just trying to survive, trying to make it through, you know what I'm saying, everything that's going on. Man, the pandemic, the police brutality and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Even with, you know what I'm saying, us as black men killing each other, like, you know, we just trying to survive and get through the next 24 hours, you know what I'm saying, without getting our head bust or slam on the ground for something that we ain't even do or something like that.
Right,
'cause every time you walk outside on the other side of that door of your house, you know what I'm saying, you facing 101 situations that you don't even probably know.
Right.
You know, so Trying to Survive, man, that's one of those songs that, you know what I'm saying, you put that on and it going to make you go harder. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You might want to make one of those decisions like, I'm going to go do this today. You know what I'm saying? When you hear that song, you ain't going to go do that. You're going to go find something else to do, some money to make or something.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're gonna redirect.
Yeah, yeah. It's got that soul in there, man. You know what I'm saying? That hip hop blues sound as well, man. And that song right there, it's kind of like, you know, it fits the mood of this year, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? And everything what people going through in 2020 right now and everything, it just fit the mood. And one of them songs that have longevity. You know what I'm saying? Right. I feel like, you know, after listening to it many a times, because I would kind of produce that record,
right?
whatnot, but just kind of like it has one of those moods that will stay around for a long time. We have some of those songs like some of Marvin Gaye songs that was going on during the 60s and the 70s, all that other stuff or whatnot, man.
Right.
It has that type of feel, but then in our generation, so to speak. And that song is, you know, we live in a digital age, so that song can come across anybody and touch anybody or whatnot. And that could be one of the songs that you could pull up and you can use it for anything or whatnot.
Yeah, it's cross-platform.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. Let's talk about End of Times. That song right there, another single that you had put out. Kind of explain to us, man, that song and how all that came about.
Oh, man, End of Time, that's one of those songs that get real deep. Man, it's just, you know, a follow-up. We're trying to survive. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Everything that's going on already been kind of talked about before me or you was even, you know what I'm saying, spit out on this earth. So it's like, sometimes it do feel like it's the end of times with all the stuff that's going on all at one time and just, you know, repetitive, just the negative shit. You know what I'm saying? I was just thinking, you know what I'm saying, writing it. It just hit me like, man, is this the end of times? Like, So that's what I sung about up on that track right there. And of course, whenever, you know what I'm saying, I heard the track, I just went into that zone.
Yeah, yeah, that's what's up, man. So, man, kind of tell the people where they can go and get the two singles and also the album, man. Let them know.
Man, on any digital platform you could think about, the album is on TikTok, Tidal, Spotify, The list goes on. Deezer. Man, you could cop the album anywhere. You know what I'm saying? You can holler at me. Slide in the DM on Instagram, official_Wrecka. Get your key to the pressure, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's everywhere, man. Floating around in the streets and it's everywhere.
Cool, cool. And you said get them keys. He got the, and what he meant by that though, he got them keys, them USB keys or whatnot. So, you know what I'm saying? If you're in the Houston area, man, make sure you hit him up, man. And he can go out and deliver you that album. And you have some you have a visual on there as well, right? To
Trying to survive.
Okay, cool, man. And that video, where we can find that video at, man?
It's on my official Vivo page. YouTube, that video, pretty much every platform that you could think about, that video is on. But it's official, my official Vivo Wrecka, and also check it out on Wrecka TV.
Okay, cool, cool. All right, cool. And Wrecka TV, that is on YouTube as well, right?
Right, right.
Yeah, okay. So, okay, cool, cool, man. And so do you have any more visuals coming out geared towards the album or anything like that, or something like that? Like a video for End of Times or any other song on the album?
Yeah, got a video coming out for a track called Can't Go For That. Another track called Fake Niggas. And yeah, End of Times as well. Yeah, we got some visuals coming. Could be coming real soon. I don't have a date just yet.
Okay.
Up on that. But yeah, we got a lot of heat coming.
For sure, man. And so let's, you know, we about to end out the interview and everything like that, man. I appreciate you coming in and you know, saying, talking about your album, talking a little bit about yourself or whatnot. For all the artists that are coming up, you know, saying, in this hip hop stuff, because right now here in 2020, the hip hop industry is wide the hell open. You know, saying anyone can become basically an independent artist or whatnot. And for you to, you know saying, start at where you started at or whatnot, what advice would you give to some artists that's kind of nervous, that are kind of, you know saying, I don't know what to do or whatnot, and for you to make that leap and complete a whole project or whatnot, and let the folks know how long it took you to make that album? Just curiosity, man.
Started on that project like earlier this year, and I actually finished that album. I finished most of that album when I was in California,
mm-hmm.
Around I think it was like March or April or something like that. But yeah, started on the project early this year, and put it out this year,
okay.
towards like the end. But man, it's about being nervous, you know what I'm saying? As an artist, an independent artist, you're going to always be your worst critic.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You just got to keep pushing. People not going to see your vision. That's for one. You know what I'm saying? Everybody not going to see your vision until you actually start doing what you have to do to accomplish everything that you're talking about. As far as, you know what I'm saying, me, man, I just went ahead and did it. No, it's just sometimes you can plan, but it's never gonna really go your way or how you thinking about it. You just gotta do it.
That's what's up. I like how you said that. You just went on ahead and just did it.
Yeah.
And you know, that message really been kind of floating around social media. Just go ahead and do what you gotta do for as an independent artist and get it out there. Cause like I said before, it's out there for the grabbing. You got a lot of people out there making their own record labels, and the record labels, they really just don't know how to adjust this year with social media and how it can affect the hip hop community. As far as just going out there, if you got something you want to say, go ahead and say it. Go ahead and put it out there. And guess what? You pay, you know, $20 a year just to put out your own music at your own frequency or whatnot. But the hardest thing to do is just initially step out there and put it out and stuff like
right,
that. And that's
right.
What you did, man.
Right.
Yeah, man. Shout out to you on that, man. So what you got upcoming up, man, in the future, man? Let us know what you're working on and all the other good stuff.
Shit, man, got another album that's coming out the beginning of 2021. That one is The Birth of Kali Hayes. That one's going to have a whole different type of vibe to it. I'm just going to have to, they're just going to have to wait and check it out,
okay,
man.
Okay, cool.
There's gonna be some more pressure applied.
Are you gonna drop any singles for it, or are you just gonna drop another whole project all at the same time?
Nah, we're gonna have some singles on that one as well.
Okay. All right, cool, cool. And let the people know also again where they can follow you at on all your social media. I'm going to give you the floor. You got it, man. Go ahead.
Man, you can holler at me, man, on Facebook at Wrecka. That's my fan page. Also, man, get at my lady, man, Chrissy Management on Instagram, GotNoLove_. You can holler at me on Instagram, official_Wrecka. Twitter, The Real Wrecka. You know what I'm saying? Just don't come hollering at me up in the streets too close, because, all like that.
Might get Wrecka. Get Wrecka, you know what I'm saying?
Bet.
And I did that because that's an inside joke. I try to make also him smile sometimes.
Right. Also, too, man, y'all, get at my man, Supa Mario, man. This man here is amazing talent, man. I couldn't do it without you, big bro. We're going to keep on grinding, keep on pushing. Jazz Creative Media, you know what I'm saying? Holla at them. Jazz Creative Studios, man. Holla at them for all your videography, all your photography, man, and all your business needs. And, yeah, it's up there.
For sure, man. Appreciate you today, man. I just want to talk about one more other thing or whatnot, man. I know you you made your first public appearance, too, at the Loud Fest, man. Kind of give us that experience or whatnot.
It was lovely, man. Shout out to Loud Fest, man. Shout out to my man Derek, man, for making it happen for me also. It was a lot of talent out there. Everybody did their thing, you know what I'm saying? Networking. It was a long time, you know what I'm saying, in the making. I'll be busting the doors open on a lot more venues and stuff like that. But
right.
Just to be welcome in Houston. You know what I'm saying? It was a big thing for me. You know what I'm saying? Everybody was cool, showed me love. You know what I'm saying? I showed love back. And gonna keep on doing it.
Yeah, man. And you know what I'm saying? Even though you got the pandemic going on and stuff like that, you was able to make a public appearance safely and stuff like that. That's pretty good, man. So people out there, man, you know what I'm saying? Y'all go ahead and, you know, whatever you working on or whatnot, whatever you got on your mind, this is a little testimony right here. This dude right here, he said, fuck it, man. I'm gonna put some music out, and that's what he did. So that's what you guys need to do, man. Make sure you go follow Wrecka on Instagram at official_Wrecka. Your YouTube channel, what is it?
Wrecka TV and my official Vivo.
All right, Wrecka TV and official Vivo on YouTube, and also Facebook page. You got a Facebook page?
Yes, sir. You got all that, man. Kali Hees and the fan page Wrecka.
All right, cool deal. I'm not even going to say Twitter, because Twitter is kind of like, you know what I'm saying? Whatnot, man.
Right.
But y'all make sure y'all go pick up Trying to Survive in the Times. There's two singles that are out right now, and also the album Wrecktified on all DSPs, digital streaming platforms. Make sure you go pick that up as well. We're going to add those two songs are already on the On The Beat podcast Spotify playlist. Make sure you go check that out, follow it, and stream those two songs as well. And we may add Can't Go For That and the song Fake Niggas. We may add that on that Spotify playlist as well, man. Again, y'all make sure y'all go get that, stream that, whatever you need to do. Follow this man right here, Wrecka, at official_Wrecka on Instagram, man. This has been the On The Beat podcast. Go ahead, chunk those deuces up, Wrecka, and we're gonna be out of here. Peace.